Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. And this afternoon I sat back and watched a movie called Body at Brighton Rock, and I knew absolutely nothing about this movie before going in and watching it at home. It sounded like a mystery detective kind of movie, like, you know, like a whodunit kind of stuff. From the title, that's actually what I thought, Body at Brighton Rock. And I was kind of sleepy and a little tired and lazy to actually go and check for something else, so I actually watched the entire thing. But a lot of my time watching the movie was also spent on my phone. It's a very low budget, I think it's an indie movie as well, written, directed and produced by Roxanne Benjamin. I was checking out to see what Roxanne Benjamin has actually done other than this, and I've seen Southbound, which I actually liked. It wasn't a great movie, but yeah, that anthology movie I actually did like it. It's a horror movie. This stars nobody I've ever known before in my life, never seen them in anything else, I guess. No one that I recognized. It's a 2009 American horror movie. And that's your part. I actually thought it was going to be something like there's a body found and, you know, detectives or police coming in. That's what I was hoping it was, but it's more of a psychological horror movie kind of thing. So there's this girl called Wendy who's a part-time employee at a state park, which is, you know, on rough terrain and all that stuff, mountainous, somewhere in the US. It's towards the end of the season, and she's kind of the person who's always late, and she's the least experienced out of all of them. So she comes in very late for the meeting and stuff. And trying to prove to her friends that she can actually take on the tough assignments, she takes a particularly rough part of the national park, the state park, sorry. And she actually exchanges with one of her, an older friend of hers, who wants to relax and flirt with one of the male employees. So she goes, she does her job, she runs into one of the friends, one of the colleagues who's got a crush on her. They start talking for a little while. Now, here's the funny thing, she keeps on putting earphones and she goes around. She ends up getting lost. She's somewhere in the backcountry, and when she takes a couple of pictures with her friends, they tell her that she's not actually in the area that she's supposed to be in, and then she's a little confused. And then they text her and ask her, who's that behind you? And she turns around, she can actually see a dead body on the ground. So then she goes and finds there's a person who's been dead, that body has been decomposing for a few days. Looking at the wounds, she actually thinks it could possibly be a potential crime scene. She loses her phone, she damages her phone, she's not getting reception, sorry. She damages her walkie-talkie and her radio. She does manage to inform them that there is a body there, but it's already a little late, so they're not able to come there. So she decides to stay and guard the site throughout the entire night while waiting for them to come in the morning. And all sort of weird things started happening. There's some noise that's coming in from a small cave nearby. She sees a rat or some kind of a creature inside the body, eating up little parts of it. And she runs into this guy. He scares her a little bit because she was looking for him and she didn't actually see him. Suddenly he's there, and he says he's a licensed hunter, and he always comes that side. She tells him he's not supposed to be that part of the state park because it's not that safe. And then she kind of runs away from him. Then she loses him, she can't find him after that. As it ends towards night, she hears a lot of noises and things like that, and then there's a scene where the body actually comes to life. I actually thought there was something going on, maybe some tribe actually doing some, maybe like an Indian tribe or something, I say Indian, a Native American tribe doing something to, and the it looks like a zombie movie because his body comes up, starts chasing her, she runs away. When she comes back, the body's still lying there, and it's all in her mind. So I think it's a lot of it is basically just psychological. She gets scared, staying all alone. The next day in the morning, she's fighting off this hunter who goes for her. She kicks at him, he falls, but she can't find the body anywhere. So she breaks her leg, she gets injured, and she's like struggling, and then she runs into a bear, a freaking huge grizzly bear. That attacks her. She's got a mace. She squirts it at him. It's not working too much, so she uses a match. A lighter, and uses it to flame it. Again, the bear's about to attack her. It bites onto her and stuff. and she's actually fighting it off, and then there's a gunshot, and it's her colleagues, along with the state police, who finally reach there that morning. It's the next morning, and they chase away the bear, and they go and tell her that, like, you know, she's actually quite lucky. She's been fighting off the bear, but that bear very well could have actually killed her. Her friends are actually quite impressed with her for actually fighting it off. And they say that she was pretty lucky. The cops are there, but they go and check this thing, and she tells them about the man that she actually saw, and they tell her that's not possible, because the man that she says, the name and all that she said, who was the hunter who was there, is actually the dead guy. So she imagined all of this stuff in her mind, and then you actually see that she's probably the fear got to her, and she's making all this stuff in her mind. Although how she would know the guy's name, I don't know. And the fact that he had the same phone, which is an iPhone, I think 6 or something like that. So there's a couple of things, and then when she realizes that it's all in her mind, she walks up to the cliff and she starts laughing, and that's when the movie ends. Stay away from the movie, it's not worth it. I would give this a 4 out of 10, please don't watch it, it's not worth it at all. I watched it for the rest of you. I think IMDb also gave it the same rating. The acting is pretty hokey, it's not really that great. The other act characters as well, not that. There's nothing much to look forward to this movie, and this is definitely not something to be watching again, because you already know what it's about. There's nothing that really would actually draw me back to this movie, so it's one for one watch and then no more. It's not really, really worth watching at all. So I would say Body at Brighton Rock, you get a 4 out of 10, and stay away from it. You don't really have to watch it. I just told you the best parts about the movie. So that's it. Thank you very much, guys. Have a good night. See you soon.